And now the fun starts. For many people, it may amount to war, but basically it is just a campaign. What do we need to do, Sing Kong?
Okay, the thing is, first thing that Wakil Calon has to do is to work out with the chief police officer what are the arrangements that are going to be made. Police officers are going to be on duty, the procedures that are going to be followed for stopping wrongful action or arresting of phantom voters or imposters. These arrangements are made beforehand so that there are no surprises on polling day. We also will have to deal with this time around, there are going to be people from Pemantau and Pemerhati. What are the relationship of all of these people going to be? Are they going to interfere with the process or help and enhance the process? These need to be worked out. They need to seek assurance from the CPO that police vehicles will not be used to ferry voters to the polling centre.
What is the limit of this polling centre?
There's a 50 meter limit. People who do not have authority cannot enter the 50 meter limit. So the Pemerhati are allowed to come into the 50 meter limit. The Pemantau will be on duty outside the 50 meter limit.
What about Longhouse used as a polling center?
that's going to be an interesting situation. I suppose this happens in Sarawak where they don't have any other facility. The Longhouse is where people live. So if you have hold it as a polling center, it's impossible to follow your 50 meter limit. How they're going to manage it without hurting the traditions or insulting the people living there, it's a tricky business, but it has to be addressed, because if it is not addressed, it is going to compromise the secrecy of, or the if it's going to compromise the integrity of the process.
Yeah, I heard stories about the wife of the Longhouse hitman coming at 5 o'clock and inviting the polling agent to go for a party.
See, the thing is, there is a 15-minute break between polling and counting, and I suppose it is a matter of courtesy when you've got guests in your house, they're taking a break, you invite them for tea. Unfortunately, this compromises the security of the ballot box.
But won't you have a situation where this particular lady has violated the election laws by entering the 50 meter zone?
This is the challenge. There is violation of electoral law in entering the 50 meter zone. There is also a compromise of the security of ballot boxes, because everybody goes out for tea, leaving the ballot box unguarded. How do we manage this without hurting the sensitivities of the native people is something that Wakil Calon has to think about.
And I believe there's a certain paper procedures that has to comply with regards to forms.
Yes.
How about Form A? Who has to sign Form A?
Oh, okay. The Code of Secrecy is... See, the thing is, every person who's involved, this was mentioned in the earlier segment, every person who's involved in the process has to sign what is called a Borang A, which is an Oath of Secrecy. The candidate has to sign the form in front of a Commissioner of Oaths before they actually allowed to be appointed. And then subsequently, they appoint polling agents, counting agents, booth agents, and other representatives. Every person involved has to sign the Borang A. But all of these people can sign the Borang A in front of the Wakil Calon.